Hello, Mark and Thornhill. As you may already know, our government announced its plan to reopen school in September. What we have come up with is an adaptable, living, breathing documents that put health and safety first. Our government has worked very hard in consultation with doctors and medical health experts and has released a plan approved by Ontario top doctor, the Chief Medical Officer of Health. Starting September, publicly funded elementary school will reopen province-wide 5 days a week. Secondary school with lower risk will reopen with a normal daily schedule, while most secondary school will start the school year with an adapted model of part-time in-person attendance and part-time remote learning with a class cohort of up to 15 students, alternating between attending in-person and online. However, if parents don't want their children physically returning to class, they are not required to do so. Parents are free to choose online or in-person classes for their children. Our safety measures are extensive. All staff and students must self-screen every day before attending school. We'll have signage to reinforce self-screening, hand hygiene, distancing, and one-way use of hallways. Staff will ensure to train students on appropriate hand hygiene to schedule break to allow students to wash their hands, and will make hand sanitizer available in bathrooms. While students in grade 4 to 12 will be required to wear non-medical or cloth mask indoors in school, students in kindergarten to grade 3 will be encouraged but not required to wear a mask indoors. All school-based staff will be provided with a mask, eye protection, and other PPE with reasonable exception for medical condition. School will significantly limit or even prohibit visitors, including parents. The Ministry of Education, the Ministry of Health, and Public Health will work closely with school board to monitor and respond to report of COVID-19 symptoms. Any students or staff members who develop COVID-19 symptoms will be immediately separated from others in a separate room where possible, and won't be permitted to return to class until cleared by public health. School must also keep record of classes, seating chart, bus cohorts, and daily visitors approved to enter the school. In addition to an extensive health and safety plan, our government is supporting school board with an additional $309 million investment. This includes hiring additional public health nurses to support schools and school boards with screening, testing, and tracing, more custodian and purchasing extra cleaning supplies and PPE for school bus drivers, and additional teachers staffing to support supervision, keeping classes small. We are also putting more money to support special needs students and students with mental health needs. In addition to school reopening in September, licensed healthcare centers will open back to full capacity on September 1st with strict health and safety guidelines. All childcare staff will be required to wear a mask. Children and staff will be screened every day while maintaining attendance record to conduct vigorous contact tracing. Frequent hand washing will be maintained. Moreover, the Ontario government, in partnership with the federal government, is providing $234 million to support enhanced cleaning costs. Safety protocol will be in place in the event a child or staff members become ill or test positive for COVID-19. For additional information, please don't hesitate to contact my office check out my website, follow my social media, or email me. Thank you for watching.